Hi, all. Everything in my video is pulled from the public domain, and I am using them under the Fair Use, Fair Dealings guidelines. Everything I say is my own opinion. You should look into this information for yourselves, but I'm pretty sure I'm right. Good morning, everybody. All right. Everybody keeps wanting to know what happened with YouTube. So very quickly, we're just going to cover that, okay? And then we're going to move on to one update on a story I talked about yesterday, and then the one big story for today. So this video is going to be kind of short, all right? But let's just jump in with both feet. Let's go. So I was sitting at the computer minding my business on March 23rd or 24th, whatever day it was that this happened. And suddenly I was signed out of YouTube, and this email came to me, which said I was in violation or repeated violations of the community guidelines. Now, if you look at the bottom of the letter, it says scamming, spamming, and deceptive business practices. Obviously, I didn't scam, I didn't spam, and I didn't know what the letter was talking about. So I sent in an appeal. I did get a response to the appeal that said the suspension was going to stay in place just for right now. I guess they were checking everything out. Now, in the middle of this, a UK journalist contacted me and said he wanted to do a story on what was going on and the YouTube channel being shut down. So I gave him an interview. He also interviewed Wally. He then reached out to YouTube and spoke with them, which is something that I can't do. He specifically asked them, I said to him, don't take just any explanation, ask for specifics. And by the next day, the channel was back on. Now, I reached out to somebody by chat after the channel was back on because nobody yet had explained to me why I had been shut down and I wanted to know specifically. The young lady that I chatted with said she was going to research it and reach back out to me, and she did. And as you can see, I was told that I was suspended because apparently I had used bots, who does that sound like, or spiders or whatever it is that they do to increase my viewers. But which I found shocking because I was only at 35,000 after almost 2 years. Like, it was taking me forever to climb up that ladder. Perfect example is the fact that I've been doing this for almost coming up on 2 years, and I had 35,000 subscribers, and that guy, Trevor Colt, has been doing it for 7 months, and he's got 35,000 subscribers. So what makes them think I was trying to buy people, I just haven't figured out. Now, as part of the letter, which I think is a form letter, it says that it was an automated system that made the mistake. I don't know about that. The timing is just a little too odd for me. But I asked her how we can avoid this in the future, how we can flag the account in the future so that this doesn't happen. And she's escalated it to internal, and it looks like, yes, they're going to flag the account so that any more mass spammings, any more mass complaints, any more mass whatever, will be investigated by a real person, not just by a computer. And that solves my problem. But that, ladies and gentlemen, is what happened. As soon as the journalist from the UK puts up his article, I'll be sure to link it for you guys because I'm sure it's going to be very, very interesting. All right, this is an update to the story I did yesterday. The friend of Megan's that died, Oli Justy, died on January 15th. And apparently she resigned from the, is it called the Mayhu? I think is how you pronounce it. She resigned from that patronage at the beginning of the year. That makes me wonder why the announcement is just now coming out in April. Maybe because nobody cared enough to announce it and she needed the publicity. Personally, I don't think she stepped back. I think they asked her to step away because she wasn't really able to do anything with them. I think they need an on-hands patron. And she did sponsor a kennel for £15. And I think it's a good thing she cut ties with the patronage because she's never going back to the UK. And I think they realized that she wasn't helping them. So I'm pretty sure the charity probably said, we need you to step down because we need somebody else. I think Sophie would be really good in this position. Now, notice the headline above. She cut her final ties to the UK, right? And she ended her patronage with the British Animal Welfare Charity. So she probably left SmartWorks as well, because SmartWorks has been asked if Megan is still their patron, and they're not replying. But since that previous headline was put out, I think she's probably dumped them too. Just another proof that she's never going back to the UK. Now, let me also point out that Meghan Markle wrote an emotional open letter sharing heartbreak, right? 3 months. Either she wrote it back in January and didn't release it till now, or she just now decided to write a letter for somebody who's been deceased for 3 months. But notice that it's the same thing she did when she wrote that letter to her dad. It was meant for public consumption. This open letter where she turns the whole thing around towards herself was meant for public consumption. But does anybody find it odd that when Megan's own uncle passed away, the one who got her that internship in Argentina or wherever she went, and Harry had to go running home from the Diana statue unveiling because of it, she didn't even give condolences to her aunt. She never spoke. She didn't pen a letter. She did nothing. Because the truth is, she didn't care. She had used the uncle. She threw him away. Because that's what she did. There is a reason why she penned an open letter. It's almost like she wants you to feel her pain and love her. Yeah, that doesn't work for me. I also find it odd that she never publicly supported her friend and nobody heard a word about him until he died. I wonder really just how good of a friend they really were. All right, let's move on now. Really quick, we have another blind item saying that one of the shopping networks is trying to get Megan to sell God knows what on their website. My guess is it would be QVC. Could you imagine a duchess on a QVC website peddling wares? I can't imagine. All right, this is another headline that just came up that I'm just touching on. They're saying that Prince Harry's favorability has gone so low, the only person below him is Meghan and Andrew. That's saying something. All right, let's move on to our main story for today. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so it was put up by Cameron Walker that Harry surprised, and I'm air quoting, he surprised the Invictus Game team UA competitors with a video call, and he was joking around with them. Now, remember that statement. He surprised them. And here they are, sitting in front of the screen, staring up at him, not noticing what's on top of the screen. Maybe they did notice. Here's a shot. Can you guys see it? Here, let me zoom in for you. Toya Holness and Violet Films. Do you see that on the top? Those are all the people that are in on the call. It's not just Harry and the Invictus Games. No. As the No Drama Zone pointed out, everything has to be taped because everything is about money. This isn't even from the heart. Good catch. Baroness Buck, who has eagle eyes, noticed Beth, and I hope I say this right, Herlihy. I hope that's right. She's part of a UA consultancy firm that was founded by two ex-palace aides. And she was Harry and Meghan's program coordinator before Megxit. Now, one of the things at the top, this is what we were pointing out, was Violet Films. Okay? You see it? And as you can see, Violet Films, along with Archewell, is producing the Invictus Games, and the distributor is going to be Netflix. So yes, any money is going to go through these companies before it gets to the people that are actually in the Invictus Games. They're making money off the backs of wounded soldiers. How disgusting is that? No wonder there's plenty of tickets still available for this. It's not sold out. People are sick over what Harry's doing with this. Now, we all know that when he gives a speech, Meghan writes his material. We know that everything has to be put out for him. All he's really good at is the small chit-chat stuff. So he's in the middle of this Zoom call, and he put out a question, and it went like a lead balloon, according to this article, and the whole room went silent. Harry goes, to the captain of the team, how are you feeling to be leading the rowdy bunch of athletes? So far, it seems like you're doing well, but the fact that they're all sitting down, you know, and everybody kind of went, oh, like, what? So the team captain said, I'm really nervous. I'm really excited. It's been a long journey to get where I am now, and continued to praise the team and everyone's efforts, to which Prince Harry insisted, as he's trying to lift the spirits of the team, as everybody was so quiet. Is everyone excited, or are you people just nervous? So, not knowing how to respond, the members of the team sat there in silence, and then everybody said, oh, yeah, we're excited. And then after the awkward moment, Harry said, well, the silence says it all, and moved on to another question. It's very awkward. I have no doubt that part will be edited right out. Now, believe it or not, one of Harry's instructors from Sandhurst was there, and he said to her, you used to yell at me so much. And she yelled back, yeah, you needed it. I don't doubt that he needed it. And Harry goes, yeah, that's cool. All right, yeah, I needed it. And then told the room that they've had 2 years to prepare for the games, so fitness shouldn't be an issue for any of them. I'm like, oh, God. All right. I, for one, think the Invictus games, which he took from the Warrior games here in the United States, I think it's a wonderful thing, but I cannot get behind it because he's making money off of it. And that just chaps my rear end to no end. Every penny should go to those people. I don't think it's right what he's doing. All right, Finn update time. I found this picture of Finn when he was a puppy sitting in my younger son's lap. And my younger son had put the picture up on Instagram and was asking for names for him, ideas and suggestions for names. And when I read his caption below, it just takes me back because he wrote, parents came home with a surprise today. He is 3 months old and is extremely shy due to abuse from last owners. Any name suggestions? Actually, we found out later on from the vet that he was actually much younger than 3 months old. Anyway, last night, as I'm laying in bed, Tigger came up, and for a second there, I thought that Tigger and Finn were going to make friends. And so, of course, I grabbed the phone and took a video. Watch this. Well, hello, Tig. Oh, somebody's a little jealous. Okay. Oh, Tigger, he wants to love you. Come on. Tail's going. Oh, my God. Are you guys actually going to make friends? All right. Oh, all right. I guess not. It's worth a try. So, again, lots of information, and you know I want your comments. What do you think about Megan penning an open letter about her friend who we had never heard of before 3 months after his death? What do you think about her finally giving up the rest of her UK patronages? Do you think she did that on her own, or do you think she was asked to give them up? What do you guys think about the surprise phone call to the Invictus Games people in the UK and the fact that it was being filmed by a filmmaker and that this is part of the Heart of Invictus and it's going into Netflix? What do you guys think about all that? Don't forget to leave your comments below. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified of future uploads. If you're already subscribed, double check that button. Make sure you're still subscribed. Don't forget you can follow me on Twitter. You can follow me on Getter. You can follow me on Rumble. You can email me. And for those who have donated to my coffee fund, thank you so much. And as always, you guys, have a great day.